Hi everyone, Shashank this side. I hope you all are doing well today. As you can see on my screen, today we will learn about designing a pipeline within AWS to execute CloudFormation template, which ultimately gonna create your AWS infrastructure with one click. Again, CloudFormation in simple word is a infrastructure as code module from AWS where we just go down our environment, which basically creates infrastructure for us from network to server to DNS as per our requirement. If you're not aware of what CloudFormation is all about, I have a video series for that. So please watch those videos to understand how CloudFormation works in background or how you design the code in form of template with the help of YAML or JSON scripting. Coming back to this video, there are few steps that we have to configure, which will create our infrastructure for us. I will show you the template as well, which I have created. So before that, let's understand what we are trying to create with code pipeline. Okay, so we have a template, which is in the form of YAML. So I used to do scripting in YAML for template. Then there is a repository, which is called code commit or GitHub. Whatever you like, just use that. We have both options to connect. So I'll be using code commit. So we will be using code commit to store our template first. Then that template will be used by our code pipeline, where code pipeline will be going to execute our CloudFormation template to execute a stack. So once the stack is created, whatever code we have written in our CloudFormation template, that will gonna create the environment for us. So this is very simple pipeline to design across your board, which you can use to create your infrastructure using CloudFormation template. And I have used this for multiple clients and it's very useful for them as well. Okay, so before going into AWS Management Console, I will show you the template. So this is the template that I'll be using. What are the things that I am creating? Public subnet. With this CIDR block, we have a private subnet. So one public, one private, and one VPC CIDR. So VPC is required, that is getting created first. Then in resource section, so these are the parameters that we have defined in the parameter section that will be using all the CIDR ranges. In resource section, we are trying to create VPC first. So this is the syntax for creating VPC. This is the type that VPC creation use. Custom VPC is the value name for that. Then every VPC requires an internet gateway. I'm creating an internet gateway and trying to attach internet gateway to my VPC. So that's a gateway to my route. Then it's a public subnet within that VPC CIDR block. Selecting our first availability zone, okay, and referencing my perf private VPC. So this is the name of the VPC, the logical name that is given over here. Okay. Now, this is the type that we have to use for creating subnets. We are creating private subnet with the same values, giving the tagging as well. Then we have a route table. So we have to create a route table, we have to use a type called route table. Now that requires a association as well. So this is the route. This is the route table inside which we are giving the route to my internet gateway, which is basically a destination as well, plus referencing the internet gateway as well. Then it's an association over here. There is a NAT gateway also getting created with a public IP, which is Elastic IP. So NAT gateway requires an Elastic IP address. Elastic IP again is static IP address in nature, which never going to be changed. Same for the private route table. So we are creating private route within that VPC. Then adding a route over here and associating the private subnet and outputting all the values in form of VPC prod for VPC, then public subnet is public subnet 1 and private subnet 1. So we can use these formats, the output, to reference in other subnets, reference in other template. That is called nested format of creating your cloud formation. So this is very simple, and again, I have used this particular template for a few of my clients as well. So this is a live scenario that I can assure you most of the companies uses. Lock down your infrastructure where you create your VPCs, your subnets, your route tables, and you can create multiple EC2 instances in other template referencing all these values. That's the best practices AWS provides, and we follow across the industry as well. I mean, I do follow that particular thing. Okay, this is the template that we will be using to create our infrastructure. So let's jump to our AWS management console. Now we have to go to code commit first, because I'll be uploading this to code commit repository that I have created. Let's see if I have something there or not. If not, then I'll create a new one. Otherwise, I'll use a existing one. My internet is slow today a bit. Sorry for that. Come on. It's taking a long time. Yep, it's opening up. Okay, I'm into the repo section. It's searching if it's having some repo or not. So let's wait for that as well. Okay, so we have a repo called pipeline, which I created almost 19 hours ago. Let's go inside this and we'll upload this template to our repo. Oh, we already have one template over here in form of YAML. So I'll be uploading a new file. Choose, then it's in desktop, VPC. Author name, I'm using mine. And okay, so let's use some random address for now. And you can use this to approve. So let's say if you're trying to implement an approval template, then you will be getting an email as well using SNS topic. You can approve that if there is an approval stage. So commit message, uploading network template. Commit changes. I'm directly uploading it to master branch. Here we go. So this template has been uploaded. We can edit whatever we want to do. Now let's go to pipeline first. I don't have any pipeline for sure. Yep, I don't have. Now let's create a pipeline. So creating a pipeline requires few things. We have to use an IAM role, and the IAM role that is getting used by code pipeline as well. Plus there is another role that needs to be created, which is for executing or giving permission to CloudFormation template to execute your resources, right? So before that, let's go to IAM. So I have, okay, let's give this pipeline name as networks. I'll be using an existing role. I have created an existing role already. Advanced setting. So you can store your artifact to your default S3. This will going to create S3 bucket. If you have a custom S3 bucket where you want to place it, you can do that as well. You can use KMS, custom KMS key as well. Otherwise, it will gonna create a new one. Click next. Okay, so let's go to IAM. Then we have a role. We must have something called code pipeline demo. Let me show you the policies. This is an inline policy which has access to all mostly. Okay, CloudFormation, CloudWatch, CodeBuild, Commit, Deploy, EC2 instances, OpsWorks, S3, everywhere it has access to, which is fine. That's why we have used this role. Now, the source, since we are using code commit, so we will be selecting code commit. Otherwise, if you have GitHub or Bitbucket or S3 or ECR, then you can use those values. Select code commit. Then repo name is pipeline that we have seen. It's a master branch. The recommended is like CloudWatch event. Use CloudWatch event to automatically start my pipeline when changes occur. So let's say if you're trying to update your network file, the template, then there will be a trigger happens to the event. Based upon that, it will going to create or update your stack. I'll be using code pipeline for now that will be checking my periodically changes. So click next. I'm going to skip the build phase because that is not required for this project. So let's skip the build phase because we already have a CloudFormation and we are using that to create our environment. Deploy provider. So you can see we have a lot of deploy provider. You can use Code Deploy, Elastic Beanstalk, Service Catalog, ECS, S3. So for us, we have to use CloudFormation because CloudFormation, again, I like CloudFormation or Terraform only because that provides us to code out our build. That's the best part that I have with CloudFormation. So that's why I use CloudFormation a lot with my AWS clients. Now action mode, we want to create or update a stack. You can create or replace the chain set as well. Again, if you're not aware of chain set, please do watch my CloudFormation videos. You will be able to know each and every function of CloudFormation. So we can do that as well. So let's do create and update stack. We can give this stack name as network. Artifact is source. And this is something I don't remember. So for that, let's go to developer tool again. Code deploy, not code deployer, code commit. So we have to use the file name that we have uploaded, the YAML template basically. Let's copy this and the name of the file has to be exact, otherwise this will not going to work. Now role, again, since we are trying to create our environment with the help of CloudFormation and code pipeline, so this is a deploy phase, that is your code deploy, which is using CloudFormation. So we have to create a role, give that role a permission to execute everything on the VPC side. So let's create a role to execute these changes. So for that, we have to go to IAM and we'll create a new role. Okay, so do we have VPC? Yes, we have. Okay, so for now, where's CloudFormation? Sorry, this is CloudFormation. Next, permission, and we will search for VPC. I'll give full access because I have to create a lot of thing over here. Next, review, write this name as network demo, create a role. Role has been created, permission has been attached. Search for role called network. It's not coming. Okay, let me copy this again because we have to refresh this page. I'll skip this build phase, CloudFormation, artifact mode is create and update the stack. Stack name is network, artifact. This is the name and here it is. So you can provide the parameters as well if you want to override. So my all parameters has been defined in CloudFormation, so I'm not going to touch that. Click next. This is the review page and create a pipeline. Let's see. You can send out a notification as well. So you have to create a SNS topic whenever you are trying to deploy in production phase or staging phase as well. I prefer to do have a notification as well and the approval stage as well, so that whenever we are anybody from the team is trying to deploy a CloudFormation, because CloudFormation again is very dangerous tool as well, because if something happens to the existing template, that will going to destroy if that is not correct, right? So we have a source code commit, it succeeded. Now it's trying to create a CloudFormation script. Let's open CloudFormation console to check if it's creating a CloudFormation stack or not. Okay, go to stacks. Here we go. It's creating a network phase, network stack. Within that, we have a lot of things that has been defined, which I have showed it to you. Public, private, and NAT gateway. NAT gateway takes a lot of all these times to create everything. So this will going to take some time. Once this is created, I'll show you what are the things that we have to do next. So we will try to add or edit few things in our code commit file here itself, and we'll check whether that triggers our pipeline to update our stack or not. So for now, I'll pause this video and resume it back once my stack is done. Here we go. Our pipeline is successful. The deploy phase has been succeeded. If we go to CloudFormation stack, this is also completed. Now let's go inside the stack to check what are the resources this has created. Internet gateway is completed. NAT gateway is completed. This is the public IP, which is static in nature. We have received that as well. Private, public, everything has been created successfully, which is good. So I'll show you VPC console as well, just to show you I'm not bluffing as well. So, okay, your VPC, this is custom VPC that has created with 172.31.0.0.16. Then we have a subnets, private. Sorry, these are the ones that I have created. Those are my previous subnets. If we go to NAT gateway, I have a NAT gateway as well created. So our stack is completely successful. The deployment is completely successful. Now next, what we have to check? I'll show you the output section. So output section is showing the export name as, which we can import in different template while creating an EC2. So these are the output export name that we can refer in our next template. Now, I want to show you something else over here. Let's try to edit our template. When I say edit, you can add your values, you can remove your values as well. So click edit. I'm editing it directly to my code commit repository, to the master branch. Okay, I'll try to remove these output section. Okay, Shashank, random email address, commit the changes. We'll try to see whether this editing will gonna trigger my code pipeline or not. Let's go back and check. So this will take again few seconds, like 30 to 40 seconds to reflect over here, because we have updated our repo. So that will take some time to trigger this pipeline. I just have to wait and see. Come on, show us something quick. Let's see our code commit. Okay, this has been committed to master. It's updated over here successfully. Yep, it's in progress now. So this has triggered my pipeline. This has succeeded to the commit. Now it's trying to update my CloudFormation template. or stack. So if you go to stack and click refresh, the update is completed. Let's refresh this. Our output section is gone. Again, output section has nothing to do. If you don't want to export these data to your next template, then you don't have to define all these values. I generally use these values while creating infrastructure template and EC2 template, because I try to lock down everything from the infrastructure point of view, because those changes will not going to update at least for next 6 months or 1 year. So I try my level best to lock down everything with the infrastructure template and use the export names to my different templates as in references. That's it guys for this particular video. I just wanted to show you how to create a pipeline with the CloudFormation integration. And again, a combination of these modules from AWS gives us a functionality to use just like a one-click deployment across your infrastructure resources. So just try it out on your account and let me know if you are facing any issue. Just place out a comment in comment section and I'll be there to help you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.